Sydney is the second least affordable city in the English-speaking world to buy a home. That's according to a new report. We rank only behind Hong Kong. Melbourne's come in at number 7, Adelaide 9th. Not good stats there. Joining me to discuss is Mark McCrindle, who is a demographer, joining us live this afternoon. Mark, thanks for your time. Yikes, this is a list you don't really want to be on, isn't it? Why is Sydney so high on it?
Well, because the population has been growing faster than we can make available houses, and so it's hit all-time records. You know, even though wages have gone up, and now the average full-time earnings is about $100,000, the house prices have been going up much faster. And so it's about 14 times average annual earnings is the average Sydney house price, putting it not only in the unaffordable category, but according to this report, the impossible category.
I mean, this is a pretty entrenched problem for the Sydney market. It's not like this is a new headline here that we're highly unaffordable when it comes to our housing. It's since the early 2000s, really, it's been this way, hasn't it?
That's true, but now even by this measure, units in Sydney, which are more than 9 times those average annual earnings, they have also landed in not just the unaffordable category, but the, quote, impossible category. So, you know, that's the challenge that we have in Sydney, and there's very few parts of our capital cities nationally that are still in that that possible category at the moment. So it's largely, you know, the supply is just not keeping up with the record demand through population increase.
What are we doing wrong? Is it the way we use land? I mean, where are we getting it so wrong?
Well, if we look at the gap between the house prices and the unit prices, it shows that, you know, we've still got more demand for houses, particularly, you know, young couples and young families. They're looking for a detached house. And, you know, the land release and certainly the building of detached homes is not keeping up. But even the units and apartments have slowed down. We've just finished a year with record population increase through migration, and yet still a bit of catch up on the building front. So as much as councils and the state government is working on this, we just seem to be overshooting on the population growth and undershooting on housing delivery.
And do we need to do, say, New Zealand, they have been identified in this report as solving the issue of that high land value, which is a problem here in Sydney and really across Australia. Do we need to actually have reforms to tackle that?
Well, yeah, I mean, a fair bit of the price here is that's built into housing is coming from taxes and various duties. So that certainly adds to the problem. But we've got interest rates that are the highest they've been for 12 years. That has an impact. You've got students starting after university or studies, their earnings years a little later. And so they're struggling to get the savings together. And that's where anything from being able to access perhaps super or getting transfers from parents that might be tax effective, all of that will help. Whatever means young people particularly can do to get that deposit ready will help them when we've just got record gap between earnings and house prices.
And the middle class was really circled out in this report in terms of the housing crisis, that it's a real threat to them. Why is this in particular?
Well, because if we look at housing and put it in its categories, even at the more affordable end, it's still way beyond the 7 or 8 times average earnings. Now, that wasn't the case 4 decades ago. The average house in Sydney was about 4 times those average earnings, and the unit was under that at about 3.5 to 4 times. Now, as I said, it's about 14 times. So that's the big challenge. It doesn't matter where people in Sydney look. It's not much different to those ratios, and so that's why we've seen a big shift of people from Sydney to regional areas and interstate as well. And with the Sydney leading the house prices nationally, it looks like that trend will continue.
Yeah, but also given Melbourne and Adelaide were also in the top 10, I mean, as a country, we're not doing that well, but Sydney obviously fared the worst. Mark, thanks for your insights this afternoon. Much appreciated.